In my dreams, I kneel before a cross in the hill, where thieves lay scattered as mounds of bone and carrion, the squawks of crows drown in rain and thunder. I stare up at the Lord, and he stares back, grave, gaunt, and terrible, his mouth curled in disgust. He steps down from the cross and walks to me. I look at the ground, but he reaches into my vision, showing me his palms. I see through the holes, thick, dark blood falling away in strings. I lift my gaze up to his face. "Do you deserve this?" he asks. "No," I answer. He grips my shoulders and pushes. I fall long enough to wonder if I will stop. I wake when I hit him. I really ought to get back to the pub. They'll be waiting on me. That light. What is that?
Captain, the temple is sealed. We'll have to find another way in.
No. Return to the others. Put these savages back from the temple. I will see to their leader myself.
You have come all this way for nothing. There is no gold inside the temple. Bring your massacre elsewhere.
Cortez men bore witness to the blood sacrifice in this artifact's honor. We have a few sacrifices to make ourselves.
You take a fatal risk in seeking out the orb. The life within is upset. It will follow you across the sea and find you.
What is this that you speak of?
The power over which you will lose control. Nothing can hold it.
I don't believe that. Get out of the way!
Don't! You'll kill us both!
I claim this in the name of God and Spain.
Fool! Run! Leave now!
It's blocking the way out. We're trapped!
No! That was not real. I should settle down before I go into another panic. How can a nightmare feel so viciously alive? Years since the murders in Whitechapel, and at night, London still hides away indoors. What is out making noise? I can feel eyes in the back of my neck. My limbs are still shaky. Not common to see a shutter unlocked, let alone wide open. I need to get off the street soon. Too easy to be followed out here. These cages are built for livestock. Doesn't look legitimate. Must be some sort of poaching operation. What was that? It didn't look like a man. I might not be as safe here as I thought.
the door. Open the bolter. Dear God, please, someone.
Oh God, help! Hurry!
What's going on down there? Hey! This is where the screams were coming from earlier. Whoever that was, I just hope they're long gone by now. If I don't find a way back onto the street, I'm as good as dead. Was that real? Or did I slip into another nightmare? I'm beginning to go off my nut.
feel more eyes upon me. I can't stand it. Something's here. What? What are all these? Where have they come from? All London is awake. I'm not dreaming. My room? Ah, how awful. I wish this wasn't happening.
Cooper? Mr. Cooper? It's John. What's going on around here?
Back away! I'll not be taken! Back!
Mr. Cooper! I'd better tread lightly. Adamson has been sacked. This is slaughter.
Jesus Christ.
Ghastly. No doubt some revenant come to haunt me. Ghastly. No doubt some revenant come to haunt me. My siblings and I knelt in this church for communion. Dug up and defiled? My sister, Moira.
Look, it's the man himself. He came back. You did it.
You're a child killer. You buried
put
her.
She's gone forever now.
You buried her.
Put her.
She's
here.
Gone forever
you
now.
Buried her.
You put her.
She's
here.
Gone forever now.
Moira, I'm so sorry. I wish I'd been more careful. I wish that I hadn't ran. I shouldn't have panicked. You! Voices! Show yourselves! This is no dream. This is an invasion. The whole city is ablaze. Landis. That bastard factory owner has some kind of hand in the slaughter. He'll be the only one to know what to do, I reckon. I just hope he isn't after himself at the site. Thank you.
industry free. I will clean the world, make it pure.
You left them behind. You abandoned your family. You don't have a leg to stand on. You can't win. It's over.
Thank you.
This instant.
This is my father's farmhouse. What's this doing here?
Thank you.
must find Mandus. There's a man on a balcony. Up there. Maybe he knows where the factory is. Hey, you! Up there!
Ah! Someone with the right number of fingers. What's a man young as you doing out here, where you'll surely be killed? I've been keeping the terrible beasts at bay. 11 for 13, it yet?
I'm out for the man who did this. Oswald Mandus. The factory owner?
Oswald? Dear boy. Well, we're the best of friends. Hunted in the Amazon together. Yes, I know him. Do you think that this chaos could really be his fault? Those fellows of the Rifle Club have been on his case for some time.
I need to know where he could be. Can you point me to the factory?
I don't know where he could be, but there is an ingress to his factory beneath the hotel.
Under the hotel? Why is there a...
liaison, my boy. He pays a yearly sum. We give his workers room and board. A handsome deal, really.
You own this place?
Indeed. What were you all about, Mandus, again?
I don't think he is alone. There is another man talking over the speakers. Someone out for blood. He seems to know Mandus intimately, I might add.
Oswald might not be well liked, but none would dare take this much fury just to him. Anyway, you are free to abscond through the cellar in my hotel to reach the factory, if it'll help you find Oswald.
Thank you, sir.
Before you go in, take care not to be seen by the hog beasts. They're intelligent. They crawled into the hotel and are roaming about, terrorizing the guests. I'll follow you in after I've finished off the ones running mad out here.
All right. I'll be careful.
Just one more thing. While you're in there, be on the lookout for my daughter, Annie. I want to know that she's safe. What's your name, anyway?
John Morn, sir. May I ask?
Thompson. Mr. Thompson. It was excellent meeting you, John. I wish you the very best of luck on your quest. Take some supplies for the road, too. Heads up.
that be Annie? Hey! Wait! Stop!
December 29th. I awoke to a loud noise coming from the cellar this morning. It was the door. When one of the maids unlocked it, there was a young lad stooping there. He was bruised badly and had cuts all over his body, especially around his legs. My father told the servants to set him in a room and tend to his wounds while father got hold of a doctor and the police. He told me to comfort the man best I could, that he was in shock and needed reassuring to get better. I asked him his name, and he said Robert. He kept asking about the others and would slip in and out of mania. I didn't know how to help him. The poor man was crying and saying that something got his friend. I tried to calm him down and tell him he's not in any danger, but he immediately cocked his head toward me and squealed, "Are you really sure? Because I don't think nowhere is safe anymore." I had no clue what to say or do. I had to leave the room for a moment.
I'm not gonna hurt you. Don't run. You'll only alert more of them. No! She can't be dead. Damn it! Why her? Jesus Christ.
Failure. John, failure. Every time, it's you who fails. Blood. All over your hands, all over them, everything you touch.
I didn't kill her. No! I didn't do anything. I'm not a murderer.
Thank you.
23rd of August. The factory side entrance is almost finished. Papa says it will bring our business further afloat, and is happier with the arrangement every day. I wonder what sort of people will come from the factory. Mother's birthday is coming up. I've put so much effort into planning the affair. Father almost thought to give the day a miss for one of Mr. Mandis's engorging feasts, but I protested him. He declined, well, emphatically at first, but after some reassuring, I think he had a change of heart.
Cellar. I'm at the threshold of the factory. Mandis can't be far ahead. Much of an extension. It was a hard fall. But here I am.
Ferguson, what are you doing?
I'm making sure nothing can get out of here once we're gone.
What about the children and the wife?
It's too late, Robert. We need to leave. We're the only ones left and we're being hunted.
What if they're alive? You could be sealing them away to their deaths.
They're already dead. All of them. It's up to us to finish what the saboteur started and burn this place to the ground. Mandus himself will be next. We're going to converge on his mansion, exactly like Michael said. He wants us to meet on the second floor after blocking all the entrances. This is very important.
Alright. Do you suppose what Eugene wrote can be true?
From what's been happening already, it doesn't sound far-fetched. No! Eugene!
Strange. No signs of attack. The pigs couldn't have got him. This was deliberate. Look at the knife there. This place must have been too much for him. There's a note in his hand. Jesus Christ.
What does it say, Michael?
What is it? Why did he do it? I can't believe it. Read for yourself.
My God.
careful with the container. That stuff will eat through metal when you get the light close up to it. Got the lantern, Ferguson?
Yes, Michael. That's about everything. We should leave now. Owen?
There's another floor on top of the disposal area that connects to the sewer. It's our best bet.
Thank you.
where now?
Past the holding pens! We're almost to the first intersection!
We'll find another way!
Just get out!
Come on, Robert! Get moving!
Maybe I can use that container to blast through this padlock.
Come on, get in! We can't wait much longer!
Just hold on! Robert's hurt! One of them got a hold of his leg! He needs help!
Where is everyone else?
They dragged Oliver away in the engine room. Eugene's up in the tunnels, and the children are either dead or in hiding.
There's one of them! Down there!
It's too late. We've had too many close calls. We can't afford to go after him.
You can't be serious. I'm going down there. You lot, go on ahead. Make sure you send the elevator back down for us.
God damn it! Fine. Just don't get us killed.
Fine? It's too dangerous to send down the elevator. What if those things use it to follow us to the tunnels? Thank you.
me go! I want nothing to do with you. This madness.
But how? Hex is the humdrum bandit legend. The Nexus is in pumps. Sorry to say, your friend Eugene didn't have much luck with that.
You went for him first.
Maybe he's just a little plain useless coward, much like you two.
One of the children and I have taken refuge in a small room. We don't dare make a peep until it's safe out there. I'll wait a while. It's been some time, and I haven't yet heard them send the elevator down from the tunnels. I triggered the engine room lockdown by pulling a fuse from the control panel, knocking out the lights as well, just in case something tries to give us the jump. It's risky to try and slip out, even though the child insists. I think we ought to both get some rest now, while the chaos has died down. The child stole away while I was asleep. I haven't a clue where he might have gone. It can't be the engine room. The fuse is still with me and the door's locked and barricaded. Did he make it to the tunnel elevator? Dear Lord, I only hope he runs into the other workers and makes it out. I'm too afraid to go out myself. This room is getting to my head. Something keeps whispering me through the seams in the wall. I swear, I saw someone else in the room with me, breathing cold air and leaving footprints. But it was nothing. Something in this room is talking. It's calling out to me, asking for help. Am I at the end of my rope already? Can a man go out of his mind so quickly? I've lost track of how long I've been here. What if I'm in the presence of the force that Eugene warned of? The very thought of Eugene having been correct with all that demonology business haunts me. And I don't think I can stomach it much longer. I'm going to sneak into the engine room through the other door. I would take a chance being torn limb from limb by Mandis's cretins, rather than suffer whatever fate looms here. I will not be taken to the depths.
sense danger in this place. Here more than anywhere. But I must push on, no matter what.
Damn, to hell with them! That's only going to let loose the man-pigs, and to leave the whole place to fall and bury us alive. Robert's right. We need to round up everyone we can hope for. The works manager, Owen, Oliver, and get the hell out of here.
Conduit. must reach him before those demons do. Oh God, where can he be? Mandus! Mandus!
Morden.
Jesus Christ! They've followed me here. I must make haste.
Daddy, Daddy, please don't kill me.
ambition has left of you. An empire of hubris, built on the backs of the miserable and infirm. A pity. Be at peace now, Oswald. I wish we could have met under friendlier circumstances. The coveted orb. How am I to fix this? Does it click? No. Not here again. What do they have planned for me now? With me, and me only. I will not let you torture them like you did me. Show yourselves. Let's get this over and done with.
Yes, Tion, it's us. It's hard to believe we're meeting at last, and with the orb safe and sound. Kind then, Sol. Give it over, and we'll take things over from here.
Why you-
Because, John, we are the body of the Void. The orb is a beautiful and terrible aperture through which your universe feeds and fosters itself. The power coursing through, it is immeasurable. Without it, we will languish and be forgotten. Make this easier for yourself. Hand it over.
You have dragged me by the nose between your world and mine, assaulted me with the unreal, brought good men to suicide to spare themselves from yous, defiled my sister's grave. I wouldn't be surprised if yous had a part to play with Oswald Mandus and his man-eating machine. I think every single one of yous have enough power already.
John, there are far more terrible and wrathful forces seeking after the orb. Your whining and protesting is doing no good for either you or us. Consider what happened to the factory workers as mercy. Because, John, what this place can do is a lot worse.
So, what is it going to be? I think my compatriots have brought up excellent points. The less resistance you offer, the more things turn in your favor. Don't make this any more difficult. You have taken a long enough time as it is. Hand us the orb before it's too late for all of us.
Not death, nor eternal torture will budge me from where I stand. I'm not going to be pushed around anymore. I'm taking control now. Yous won't be getting the orb. Not now, not ever.
John Morlin, you are wasting our time. Quick, take it from him before it hurts.
What's that?
Is something else here with us?
No, it's here.
What's here? You didn't tell us something else was here with us.
Jesus, what's happening now? Who are you? I've seen you before. I know you. Please, I want to put this all behind me. Let me go. I never meant anyone any harm. Please let me go. The keeper of the orb carried me safely back to the world above. My feet landed softly on the streets of London as I awoke. I was still afraid, thinking I would once again be at the heel of the pig beast's rampage. But there were none to be seen or heard as the city stood still, bracing itself for the new year. My sister's death was an accident. I realize that now. The demons exploited my guilt, my grief, and I fought back. In the end, she was the only thing protecting me from giving in. The ordeal is over, and London has survived at a great cost. I came back to the Damson Templar, hoping the Cooper family made it through the night. But just as in my visitation to the Void, the pub was destroyed, patrons having drank their last, and the Coopers lying in each other's arms, holes in their heads. I feared that if the premonition came true, so will the fate of my brothers. I will flee London and England, and return home to my family. I can do nothing for Moira, but my brothers still have a chance to live. This is my responsibility to save them from the upcoming wars. I will step down from my cross on the hill. I will come to meet the future halfway, and stop.